I'm here with Rosemary Watkins. We put it out to the community asking them to submit questions, and I've got a couple here for you if you don't mind. So the first one is, how to help my husband let go of things. He grew up poor and feels like he's chucking money out, and then he gets concerned that he may need the item someday. And then a question that I often get asked at workshops is how to start the clutter conversation with a loved one.
Yes, it's a very important conversation, and many people like to know how to do that. It's
yes.
like bringing any hot topic up with a loved one, I think, and in families. But it's very important, that authenticity and being willing to have those hard conversations or hot topic conversations with someone. I'll start with that maybe, and looking at then how to do it with the person who's sounds like has some fear around maybe poverty, or
yeah.
maybe has some background in not having had enough, or and again that would link with a deprivation loss, rather than again the experience of not having had enough or being deprived of something
right.
that can lead to fear of future deprivation and future experiences of that. And that certainly can be big for many people in coming to hold on to lots of things now that they can and can afford to buy and so forth.
Yeah.
So I think starting that conversation, there's a kind of two-tier step in having conversations that are challenging with families and family members. And the two tiers are generally to ask questions first from them, like to find out where they're at with something
right.
is usually a useful place to go, like how they're making meaning, how they're making sense of something, how they're experiencing it, basically their view on something. And second tier then will be to look at the differences between you and them.
Right.
Yeah, so that's, if you keep that in mind, that can be
okay.
So it's that sense of inviting the questions and then speaking to the differences in between the two of you around the topic.
So could you give me an example, please? So if let's say we've got a really cluttered garage,
yeah,
and I want to have the conversation with my husband.
Yep, and he's the guy fearful of being deprived again or having
yes.
deprivation perhaps.
Yep.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
Yeah, so beginning to find out like what his thoughts are on that, on the keeping all of the stuff that's
yep.
In the garage, and his plans for them, his plans for use of them, how he sees it, if he's troubled by it,
right.
whether it bothers him in any way. And then also the fears. If he begins then to speak about, I might need it one day, that sort of thing, and that's why I'm holding on to it, then, you know, that element of fear, deprivation or scarcity, again,
right.
it can come from that scarcity rather than an abundance, which seems obvious to others, you know, in the garage. So being able to hear him out is the first place. Many people try to speak to them in a kind of demanding way that they do something about it and
right.
change the behavior. And really, it doesn't work for anybody,
no.
no matter whether it's children or teenagers or partners
yeah.
or adults. When we start demanding that they do things our way, it's generally not going to work.
Yeah.
So that invitation, genuinely inviting and genuinely being interested enough to sit and listen and hear them out, and to then empathize with that sense of fear
right.
that's underpinning it. And the partner may not have even realized that there's fear behind that. So if the, you know, they can help him see the fear that's there of not having enough in the future based on not having enough in the past, for example.
Right.
And then that can be really helpful to them. And this is the way our human mind works. You know, our mind is brilliant at predicting the future based on the past. So minds will tend to go there
yes.
and say, yes, you were poor once or didn't have enough, and you will be poor again if this. So that's part of how it goes. So then speak, once you've elicited that and hear him out, say, and are you aware, or, you know, I'd like to share my different way of looking at this with you. Will you be willing to listen to me? And bringing up your different way then of looking. And then talking about the impact as well on you, maybe your needs for that garage or the room, you know,
yep.
that's in the house that's shared space, and how you might enter some kind of negotiation around it with him. So something in that shared, genuine conversation and interest can go a long way towards making a difference in how we bring up the conversations around clutter with a loved one.
Lovely, thank you.